So learning really is a very, very difficult thing to do for most of us. And one of the most important aspects of learning is failing. So you try something, and you test your assumptions, you test your fundamentals, you test your hypothesis, and the only way you're going to learn is by failing. And when you present a solution and you say that the solution works, behind that working solution, there's probably 9 or 10 or 100 iterations that didn't work. And every one of those has been a learning opportunity to the people involved in it. STEM education takes you through step by step. The acronym stands for science, technology, engineering, and mathematics. In STEM, you try something and it doesn't work, then you go back to the root cause. Maybe it's something really simple. Maybe it's something vital, fundamental that we're overlooking. We can't create something out of nothing, right? There's laws of conservation, laws of energy that govern the physical world. So in that process of thinking, there's a lot of learning that's taking place. And there are examples really abound in history because in some instances, and these are truly visionaries, you look at mathematicians in the 17th and 18th centuries, they came up with theories, the applications of which did not develop until the 21st century. But now that we have the application, we're finally beginning to figure out how those theories apply to the application that we have in hand. So it's a matter of being both able to look forward, which is a progressive way to look at it, as well as look behind, retrospectively, to see what theories exist that may come to bear upon current technologies and allow us to understand the physical world in which we live.